Do you want to create an Oracle database to use for free? Oracle offers a cloud-based Oracle Free Cloud Database, which you can sign up for and access using a tool like SQL Developer on your own computer, all for free. In this video, I'll show you how to sign up for the account, create the database, connect to the database from SQL Developer, and run a few SQL statements on the database. Also, this process should work on the M1 MacBook computers, so you can run Oracle on your MacBook. Other methods of running Oracle on a Mac, such as Oracle Express, Docker, or a virtual machine, don't work yet, at the time of creating this video. Because this is a cloud-hosted database, all you need is SQL Developer on your M1 MacBook, or even another IDE, and you should be able to connect. Let me know in the comments if you're on an M1 MacBook, have tried the steps in this video, and it doesn't work. So let's get into it. We'll start by creating an account on the Oracle website for Oracle Cloud Free Tier, which is Oracle's free level of their cloud service. We'll do this by visiting oracle.com/cloud/free. You'll see this webpage here. This page explains a little more about the Oracle Cloud Free Tier, which you can read if you like. For now, click on the Start for Free button. This is the registration page. Enter the details on this page: country, name, and email. Complete the CAPTCHA check and click Verify My Email. Once the page says Email Verification Link Sent, you'll then be sent a verification email. Click the link in the email to verify, and you can resume the sign-up process. It's opened a new tab with the details populated already. Enter a password for your Oracle Free Cloud account that adheres to the guidelines given. You can enter a company name if you like, or leave it blank. The cloud account home is automatically populated, but you can change this. For your home region, select one that's near you. I'll select Australia, Southeast Melbourne. Then click on the Continue button. On the next page, enter your address information and phone number and click Continue. The next step is this payment verification section. Now, this is a free tier and you won't be charged unless you elect to upgrade the account, as mentioned on the page here. You may see a small temporary charge as part of the verification that will then get removed, but you'll need to enter a payment method as part of the sign-up process. So click the Add Payment Verification Method button. Click the credit card button on the pop-up that appears. Enter in the remaining billing information, as much of it has already been populated. Scroll down and select your card type. Enter the card details and click Finish. The payment method will be processed and you can click Close when it's done. Once it's added, tick the checkbox in the agreement section and click Start My Free Trial. Your account will then start being set up. After a minute or two, you'll see this thanks page. It says your account has been created and to check your email. You should receive an email soon titled Get Started Now with Oracle Cloud. In this email, you'll see a link to sign in. Click the Sign In button. You'll be taken to the Oracle Cloud Account sign-in page. Enter the email address and password you specified during the setup process and click Sign In. Click Skip on the Tell Us About You window or select the areas that interest you. You'll be shown the Get Started page within Oracle Cloud. There are a lot of things you can create inside Oracle Cloud, and the services you can use for free are tagged with Always Free Eligible. The one we're looking for is the database, which is labeled Create an ATP Database, where ATP stands for Autonomous Transaction Processing. Click the button here, and you're taken to the Create Autonomous Database page. This is the page you can use to create your database. The first few sections are automatically populated, and you can leave them as the default values. For the workload type, you have a few options, but we can leave the default value of Transaction Processing. Leave the shared infrastructure selected by default. Scroll down and toggle the always free configuration options to display. This will mean only the free options are selectable, making it easier to complete the form. You'll see an information section here about idle usage of the database, which is good to know. At the moment, the only database version available is 19c, which should be enough for our needs to get started. Scroll down to the administrator credentials section. Enter a password for the admin account. This is the password for the database, which you'll use when creating a connection in your IDE, such as SQL Developer. leave the default selections of Secure Access from Anywhere and License included. Finally, click Create Autonomous Database at the bottom of the page. The database will start being created and will show an orange provisioning icon here. About a minute later, it will change to a green available icon. The database is now created. The next step is to connect to it. In order to connect to the database from a tool like SQL Developer, we need to create something called a wallet. To do this, click the DB connection button here at the top. A new window will open. The wallet type here can be left as instance wallet. Click download wallet. Enter a password for this wallet. This is a new password, different from your Oracle Cloud account password and your database admin account password. It's used in some IDEs to be able to log in and use the connection. Once the password is entered, click download. A zip file is generated and you're prompted to download it. Save it to somewhere on your computer. Now that our database is created and we've created the wallet, we can connect to the database using SQL Developer. Open SQL Developer on your computer. If you don't have it installed, you can download it pretty easily from the Oracle website. Click on the green plus icon to create a new connection, or click the arrow next to it and select New Database Connection. We don't want to select New Cloud Connection because that's for a different service. A new connection window will appear. Enter a name for your new connection. I've entered Oracle Free Cloud. Enter a username of admin and leave the role as default. Enter the admin password that you provided on the database creation page. This is not the wallet password that you just created. Select Save Password if you want the password to be saved on the connection. For the connection type, select Cloud Wallet. Then click on Browse and select the zip file that was downloaded from the Oracle website when you created the wallet. Now click on Test. If all goes to plan, this should say Success after a couple of seconds. Your connection has worked. Click Save to save the connection, then click Connect. If you get any error messages, ask about them in the comments below. A few seconds after you click Connect, you'll see a new SQL editor connected to your database. We'll create a sample table and run a few queries to test it. We'll create a table called MyTest with a single column called NewValue. Once you've written this statement, click Run. The table is created. Next, we'll insert a value into this MyTest table of Hello. Run this statement and you should see one row inserted. Now run a select statement on this table. You should see the output of Hello in the results section. And that's the end of the tutorial. You've successfully created a database on the Oracle Free Cloud service and connected to it using SQL Developer. You can then use this database to practice your SQL and create more tables and data. Let me know in the comments what other videos you'd like to see on this Oracle Cloud database. And that brings us to the end of this video on creating and connecting to an Oracle Free Cloud database. If you learned something new from this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn more about database design and development, visit databasestar.com. That's where I share my best database-related content. Which tip from this video was the most helpful? Was it the step-by-step process to create the database, or using the wallet feature to connect to the database or something else? Thanks for watching.